Hello students, welcome to the class of Applied Zoology. We are going to learn study of equipments used in sericulture. The first equipment is rearing stand. Rearing stands are made of wood or bamboo and are portable. These are the frames at which rearing trays are kept. A rearing stand should be 2.5 meter high, 1.5 meter long and 1 meter wide and should have 10 shelves. The trays are arranged on the shelves and each stand can accommodate about 10 rearing trays. Second equipment is rearing trays. Rearing trays are used for rearing silkworm and are placed on rearing stand. There are many kinds of trays differing from one another in material, shape and size. Traditionally, rearing trays are made of bamboo or wood so that they are light and easy to handle. These are either rounded or rectangular. Nowadays, rectangular plastic rearing trays are widely used in rearing of silkworms. Third important equipment is antwells. Antwells are provided to stop ants from crawling onto the tray as ants are serious threat to silkworm. They are made of concrete or stone blocks 20 cm square and 7.5 cm high with a deep groove of 2.5 cm running all around the top. The legs of the rearing stands rest on the center of well filled with water. Here in the diagram, you can see cocoon storage racks which are provided with the ant well. Next equipment is chopping board. Chopping board, it is made of soft wood used for cutting the leaves of the mulberry used for feeding the young silkworms. The size is 0.9 meter by 0.9 meter and 8 centimeter thick. Next equipment is chopping knife. Chopping knife is used for cutting the mulberry leaves. It generally have blade of length of 50 centimeter long and 3.8 centimeter broad, provided with strong wooden handle. Cut leaves are fed to chalky edge silkworms. Next equipment is feathers. Large white burr feathers are important for rearing worms. These are used for brushing newly hatched worms to prevent injuries. It is also helpful while changing the bed. Next equipment is chopsticks. Chopsticks are tapering bamboo rods of about 17.5 to 22 cm long and thin and tapering to the end, about 1 cm in diameter. They are meant for handling and picking younger stages of larvae to ensure the hygienic condition and to prevent damage to young silkworm. It helps to prevent contamination of disease among silkworm. Leaf preservation chamber. Leaf preservation chamber is used for storing harvested leaves. The sidewalls and bottom are made of wooden stripes. The leaf chamber should contain good number of ventilators covered with wet gunny cloth. This will help in maintaining leaf quality. Otherwise, leaves should be scattered on the floor in a single layer so that the water droplets on the surface of leaf will be evaporated. Leaf should never be preserved in heaps. Next equipment and the most important equipment used in the sericulture is mountages, which is also called as cocoonage and chandrika. Mountages are also known as Kakunej or Chandrikas, which play a vital role in quality of cocoon production. It is used as support for the silkworm to spin cocoon during pupation. The matured silkworms are transferred onto mountages so that they start spinning cocoons. Farmers, depending upon their resources, use different types of materials like bamboo, plastic, dry straw, rotary card, and coconut broom sticks as are available locally for making mountages. Traditionally, mountages are made up of large rectangular bamboo mat tied on bamboo sticks for support, and on the surface of bamboo mat, spirals of bamboo tapes having the gap of 5 to 6 cm. Nowadays, plastic mountages are also known, which are known as Netrika. These are widely used as they are light in weight and available at low cost. Cocoons from plastic mountages can be easily removed with delicate cocoon harvester machine in quick time, so no requirement of extra labor is there. These are some of the mountages. The first diagram shows traditional bamboo mountages, which is called as Chandrika. And the second two diagrams, they are plastic mountages, which are known as Netrika. Thank you.